Hello and welcome. The Yuzu team continues to amaze everyone with a highly anticipated update. After the incredible up to 400% improvement in ASDC texture quality that we discussed earlier, you can check out the video in the card. We are excited to share the latest news. As many of you have been waiting for, following the improvements in ASDC textures, we have finally achieved the incredible milestone of over 60 FPS in the game Bayonetta 3. Now, delays and cutscenes are a thing of the past, and there are no more issues with distorted ASDC textures. Before we delve into the details of this exciting update, remember to leave a like and subscribe to the channel to stay updated with all the latest emulation news firsthand.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
And finally, the experience of playing Bayonetta 3 is about to become something incredible thanks to Yuzu. If you want to access this exciting update, simply update your Yuzu Early Access version to any version above 3840. And what we have here is nothing short of an impressive performance gain of up to 63%, depending on your system. But that's not all. Crucial fixes have been made, including improved audio and video synchronization, as well as the elimination of texture deformities that used to plague the game. Additionally, the rendering of the game's fog has been adjusted, although it's not yet absolutely perfect. I remember how the fog was practically non-existent before these improvements. Now, with confidence, I can state that this is the perfect time to dive into this game, which is nearing perfection. And, as you've been expecting, I've prepared a visual comparison to showcase the incredible difference that this update has brought to the game. As soon as the update is fully stable, I will be releasing a video that will guide you through the best way to enjoy Bayonetta 3, highlighting all the new pros and cons of the latest emulator versions. Surprisingly, right in the test of the first area of the game, where we encounter two massive enemies in a wide environment, significant gains are already noticeable. The frame rate has increased from 22 FPS in version 3838 to 44 FPS in 3841. It's noteworthy that stutters are practically non-existent now, with the 1% low increasing from a surprising 3 FPS in the previous version to 19 FPS in 3841. It's important to mention that the shaders were already compiled, as I had played this part before. The game is running in its native resolution, but if you want to further increase performance at the cost of minimal loss of accuracy, you can opt for the normal mode in the GPU settings. At the end of this initial test, the statistics are impressive. In version 3838, the average FPS reached 33, with a minimum of 3 and a maximum of 77 FPS. However, in the new version, the performance is notably superior, with an average FPS about 58% higher during this initial test, reaching an average of 52, a minimum of 30, and a maximum of 80 FPS, with a 1% minimum of 19 FPS. During moments with fewer enemies in denser areas of the city, the game still presented performance below expectations. This made precise movement a true challenge, especially for those who have already experienced Bayonetta, particularly on higher difficulties. We know how crucial precision is to execute movements at the right moment. Now, with the implemented improvements, these actions flow much more smoothly. In this specific part of the game, we were able to reach a maximum of 58 FPS in version 3841, while in version 3838, the limit was only 27 FPS. The minimum reached 20 FPS. It's worth noting that to experience the game in its entirety, maintaining a constant frame rate of 30 FPS is essential. Let's discuss the intense battles involving gigantic enemies in the middle of the city. Here, the difference is even more noticeable, surpassing even what was mentioned initially in the update description. While the previous version only achieved a mere 20 FPS in certain moments, the new version manages to reach an impressive 63 FPS, representing a significant increase of 215%. As mentioned earlier, the difficulty of moving and executing precise movements in the previous version, which was limited to 20 FPS, was noticeable. When comparing these moments, in version 3838, the maximum frame rate reached 33 FPS, while in 3841, this number rises to 72 FPS. We still encounter sequences with majestic structures, numerous particles, real-time destruction effects, and areas filled with moving elements. Here, the difference between the two versions becomes even more evident. Both struggle to maintain an average of 30 FPS, and it's important to highlight that it's not possible to confirm if this issue also occurs on the original hardware. It could be a limitation, something that often happens in games, as is the case with Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. However, in this scenario, we find the greatest FPS drop in the previous version, reaching a minimum of 7 FPS, while the new version manages to maintain an average around 17 FPS in this context. After this initial drop, the new version maintains an average above 40 FPS, while the previous version continues to struggle to reach 20 FPS, making each jump seem to take an eternity to reach the ground. Finally, the real-time scenes now work exactly as they should. As you can see in the background video, there are no more strange objects during the scenes, and the synchronization between audio and video is perfect. This is undoubtedly the best time to fully enjoy everything the game has to offer. And you, have you already finished Bayonetta 3 before, or were you waiting for improvements, just like me? Leave your opinions in the comments. I'm very thankful to everyone who has followed the video up to this point. See you in the next one, and until then, take care.